Mesdames et messieurs, Pascal de Salle de retour for another episode of Pep Talk UK Television. First of all, libérez Booba, libérez Caris, free Booba. For those of you who don't know, two various big rappers in France currently incarcerated for a big fight at Orly. It's another story, we can talk about that some other time. But today we will talk about the game that took place recently at Wembley between Manchester City and Chelsea. Pour in regards to the committee shield, to the charity shield. Now, you know, the result was what I expected. You know, for those who remember the pre-match video, I did say that Manchester City would win 2-1. The final score was 2-0. Aguero scored both goals, you know, and Aguero is in good form, very good form. Perhaps had Argentina played Aguero in the World Cup, you could have been a different, you know, certainly a different outcome. But, you know, for Manchester City, he doesn't stop. He's still the very much the threat that you expect from the quality player that is Aguero. And, you know, I must say that Manchester City looked better prepared, more fresher. You know, they do have the consistency of management in Pep Guardiola. Pep prepared them very well. As said before, Pep does not like to lose. So even if you were to play for a pineapple, Pep would want to win. That's just the desire to win, the will to win. That is certainly comes from Pep Guardiola and is transferred into the team. So the team, you know, played very well. They also introduced Riyad Mahrez. Mahrez had a good start, you know, so Sané played on the left. Mahrez played on the right. You know, so it certainly was quite troublesome for Chelsea. Chelsea are missing my friend N'Golo Kanté. N'Golo is very missed. More pertinently and more concerningly for Chelsea, and for a lot of Chelsea fans that will agree with me, is that Morata, man. Morata, qu'est-ce qu'il y a? I do not understand Morata. Morata is not the player that we are used to seeing, you know. He's missing a lot of chances. It feels to me that Chelsea need to buy another striker, another big-name striker, because Morata is not cutting the mustard. La moutarde, elle est pas coupée. He does not cut the mustard so far. And it's important for Chelsea to recuperate that form, you know, and they need a striker. They need somebody to change the game, you know. If they could get back Diego Costa or whatever they need to do, you know, Hudson-Odoi had a good game, decent game, you know, a lot of people in England rate him highly, better than my friend Kylian Mbappé, but it's not true, it's not true at all. Good prospect, but Hudson-Odoi, you are not Kylian, that is not true. However, he played very well, as expected. He's still very green, he still needs to, you know, needs more game time, but very surprised that Morata and Chelsea have not yet addressed the striker position, and the defensive midfield was also was not very good from Chelsea. Defensively also, they looked very poor. David Luiz wasn't able to deal with the oncoming threat of Aguero, you know, and also it seems to me that the Chelsea players still have a bit of time to adapt to the playing style of Sarri. But look, it will take some time, you know. It was a depleted Chelsea squad. But in saying that, Manchester City proved that they are certainly the best team in England. You know, as an Arsenal fan, it's going to be concerning to face them because they look very fresh. They look much better. You know, they play intuitively, you know, And I still believe that Arsenal still have a lot to play for. And they're not quite there yet. But as of today, the performance from Manchester City, you know, remains the same. They picked up from when they left off last season. They played very good football. I expect Manchester City to remain contenders to win the league again. You know, it's going to be a very interesting league, you know, and Manchester City, Pep Guardiola, are proving to be world beaters, and they certainly want to go on and dominate English football for a very long time. That I believe they can. They still have to do better in Europe, but as far as, you know, the team is concerned, and as far as Pep Guardiola is concerned, Manchester City are here to stay as long as he's there and as long as he's managing the team. Where do Chelsea go from here? I mean, there's still a few days until the end of the window. But for me, they need to come up with a striker because Olivier Giroud comes back. Giroud is a good player, but he's not that, you know, that marquee striker that, you know, Chelsea fans are looking for. And Chelsea are crying out for a big player up front, you know, a striker with a big personality, a striker that can change the game all on his own, as Aguero does for Manchester City. There is that requirement for Chelsea to galvanize and to get themselves a striker. At this moment in time, it's very difficult because I do not think that any team would want to give up their talisman player, you know, with a few days to go. But it'll be interesting to see where Chelsea go from here, because Chelsea do also have to address Arsenal in the second game of their season. So it'll be good to see how they regroup from there. This, you know, is work in progress. New manager, it does take a bit of time, and it'll be good to see, you know, how Chelsea will perform. You know, I don't think they'll be out of the title race per se. They will be competitive, but it may take them a bit of time to adjust to this new playing style and also to the demands of the new manager. But in saying that, you know, would love to hear from you, love to hear your comments, you know, your suggestions, and look forward to hear from you. You know, as I said before, follow us on all of our platforms, on Instagram, Pep Talk UK, on Twitter, Pep Talk UK, on Facebook, of course, Pep Talk UK. Je suis Pascal, mes amis, mes copains, Probiz, Shazmak, follow us all, and we'll bring you the best, you know, in football and boxing. À la prochaine. Au revoir.